Welcome you all students. In the past couple of video lectures, I taught you how to construct cycloid, epicycloid and hypocycloid. And here I have a question for you. In this, I can say this question is a bit challenging for you to identify the exact curve, as well a bit hard in the construction part. Okay, fine. Just read out the question. A thin circular disc 50 mm diameter is allowed to roll without slipping from upper edge of sloping plank which is inclined at 15 degree with the horizontal plane. Draw the curve traced by the point on the circumference of the disc. Okay, so we are familiar now cycloid, in the sense if a rolling circle rolls on the straight line path, we shall call it as a cycloid. If it is a epicycloid, we shall say if a rolling circle roll above or outside of the another circle. If the rolling circle rolls inside of the another circle, we shall say it is a hypocycloid. And here we have the concept. I can show you the exact pictorial say about this question. Okay, so first a circular disc is there. Circular disc is roll without slipping from the upper edge of sloping plank which is inclined at 15 degree with the horizontal plane. Okay, so that means the exact picture is there is a horizontal plane, and with it there is a plank which is making 15 degree, and the upper edge we have a rolling circle. Okay, upper edge we have a rolling circle. So this is the exact arrangement from the question, I can say. So here it is at the top without slipping from the upper edge. Am I right? Allowed to roll without slipping from the upper edge, right? So I can say naturally it rolls in the anti-clockwise direction in order to trace out the curve. Okay, so I can say if you have a better imagination, if it rolls in the anti-clockwise direction from the upper end to the lower side, you could see the trace of the curve. That means point on the circumference of the circle will do something like this. Okay, so from this we can conclude it is nothing but a cycloid. Okay, so the thing is, there only one difference is there in the basic cycloidal curves or basic cycloid. Rolling circle will be there, then there will be a horizontal table surface or a straight line. But here as well we are having the same horizontal straight line, but the straight line is somewhat inclined to 15 degree. That's the change. So we are going to construct now the cycloid. Okay, so first try to take all the given data. So here we have the circular disc, okay, which is nothing but a rolling circle. I'm going to take it as capital D as 50 mm. That means radius as 25 mm. Now just we can start our work. So first here we have to start from the platform. Always in the cycloid we will be starting our curve from the rolling circle, am I right? Here we are going to start from the platform. That means first take your scale and just draw a very good horizontal line. Okay, so you can draw here, just draw a very good horizontal line, and then placing at this end. That means place your protractor and just take 15 degree, because the plank is inclined 15 degree, right? So keeping like this manner, go and read 15 degree and have a line, inclined line. So you will get like this. So extend at maximum. And next step is, now the platform is ready with the angle. So with the angle 15 degree, Next step is the rolling circle. So we must place the rolling circle. Since the platform is done in the first, placing the rolling circle is quite challenging. So please do listening how I am going to place the rolling circle here. Okay, at the end, in order to draw the rolling circle, at the end just have a 90 degree line, just have a 90 degree line, and then measure 25 mm in your compass and keep at this point, end point, and just have a cut mark so that you could identify the point, which is nothing but center of the rolling circle. See, this is the center of rolling circle. Now with the same measurement of 25 mm in your compass, just place it on the point C and go for a circle. Okay, so if you do so, you can see the circle, you can see the circle as this. Okay, you can get like this. Now see, if we extend this line to the entire circle, we can divide this circle into two equal parts. Always in general, to obtain all the tracing point, we used to divide the rolling circle into 8 equal parts, right? The same work has to be done here. Okay, so for which, just keep your protractor as this manner, as this manner, and read 90 degree and go for a line passing through the center. So you will get like this. And next, place the same protractor with the same position and just read out 45 degree and go for a line passing through the center, so that you will get like this. In the opposite side, you can measure 45 degree and go for a line passing through the center, so that you could see the separation, that means rolling circle separation into 8 equal parts like this. Okay, so now the next step is, we need to give the naming for each and every points in the circumference of the circle. So we are thorough in knowledge, because it is slip without slipping, that means roll without slipping from the upper edge, am I right? So it is just rolling in the anti-clockwise direction. So our rolling circle is rolling in the anti-clockwise direction. So always we used to do the notation just reverse of the motion in the rolling circle, right? That means from the next of the bottom contact point, I going to give in the reverse. That means here it is anti-clockwise direction, so my naming is going to be in the clockwise direction. So this is 1 and this is 2, this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this is 8, like this. Okay, so now the rolling circle is ready. The next thing is the platform. So here in the question, there is no say about revolution. Okay, so in general, we will be taking 8 for 1 complete revolution. So we are familiar in the formula for the 1 complete revolution, nothing but the circumferential length of the circle, pi into d. So if you take the calculation, you can say pi into 50, you get 157 mm. So next, just from the 8th point, keep your scale in the horizontal manner, something like this. Okay, and just read out 157 and just have a marking. Approximately you can get here. Okay, so just measure it and go for a marking at the end. Here it is taken with the measurement 157. So here it is. So in order to just have the platform to make the rolling circle to roll, what you have to do is, this is the end point, right? So from this have a 90 degree line, from this have a 90 degree line, and next from the top end of the circle, just have a parallel line to this plank. Okay, just have a parallel line to this plan. So you will get a boundary like this manner. So add a 90 degree line from the end of 157 line, and then next from the top end of the circle you just add a parallel line to the plank, just like this. Now the same work, just like what we have done in the rolling circle, we have to do in the this platform. Okay, that means we have to divide it into 8 equal parts. So for which the same thing, the bisection we are going to follow. So bisection in the sense, here this is our etc rectangular part. Okay, so first try to divide it into 2 equal half. So for which take more than half of this portion and just keep at the one end and go for an arc, and then from the next end with the same measurement just have an arc, so that you will get an intersection point. From that you have to drop a 90 degree line. Just drop a 90 degree line. Okay, so now it is divided into 2. So again, how to follow the same for the rest of the segments. So now this is my segment and this is the next segment. So just take the more than half of this segment, go for a cut mark, and from the opposite end with the same measurement have a cut and have a line 90 degree. Then just take more than half and have a cut mark. From the next end with the same measurement have a cut mark and drop a line just 90 degree to the plank. So now read 1, 2, 3, 4. Our exact thing is we have to divide it into 8 equal parts. Again continue it. So this is the segment, go for a cut mark by taking more than half with the same measurement. From the other end go for a line. Then this is the segment, take more than half and with the same measurement from the other end go for a line, 90 degree line, so that you will be getting the separation. Just do it for the rest of the segment. You could see the things like this. Okay, now it is equally divided into 8 equal parts. So now the naming should be given. Now the naming should be given. So first, this is the first point. From the right end to, I am going to give the from the right to left, I am going to give the naming, since it is rolling from the top to bottom. Okay, so this is the first point. So I am going to give this as 1', and this is the second one, 2', this is that, and 4', and this one the 5', and this one as 6', this one as 7', and this one as 8'. Okay, so the rolling circle is ready and the platform is ready. The next thing is we must take a line from each and every point in the circumference, from the circumference of the circle. So take a horizontal line, just that means we have to take a line which is parallel to this plan. Remember it, not a horizontal line. You have to take a line just parallel to this plan. Okay, so if you take a line, I can say 1 and 7 will comes in a same path. It goes like this. And next, if you take a line from the second point, you can say 2nd, 6th, as well the center locus comes in a same locus. Like this. And next, if you take a line from third and 5 comes in a same line. So you could have a line like this manner. So now it is ready to pick all the trace point to identify the profile of cycloid. Okay, so next step, just measure the rolling circle in your compass. Just measure the rolling circle or take 25 mm in your compass. Okay, and go for a cut mark. So before that, we need each and every centers, right? So here is this locus line coming from the center. So just here is the first line intersecting. So this must be your C1, first center C1. And here it is intersecting with the second. So this is the C2. And here it is C3. And here it is C4, C5, C6. C7, and here C8. Okay, now take the measurement of radius 25 mm in your compass, or take the radius from the rolling circle and keep at the point C1 and just look for the first locus line. So here it is, and go for a cut mark. You will get approximately here, and with the same measurement, just keep your one leg of your compass on C2 and look for the second line. Here it is, the second line. So you are keeping like this and just have a cut mark so that you will get like this. Next, from the C3, look for the third line and go for a cut mark. So you can see here as this, and keep at the C4 and have a cut. You will get the point in the maximum at the top, and from the C3 have a cut in the fifth line. You'll get like this. Next, keep at the C6 and have a cut in the sixth line. You'll get as this. And next, keep your point compass on the C7 and search for the seventh line and have a cut. You'll get like this. And next, from the C8, just have a cut. You'll get at the end. We are familiar. If it is a cycloid, it starts from the 8th point and it comes to the maximum at the 4 dash, and it ends at what, 8 dash, okay? So just try to trace out the path by joining all the points which you have picked with the smooth hands. Just join with the smooth hand. First of all, you have to use the 2H pencil, and once it is traced in a clear manner, you can go for a HP pencil, okay? So then you can give the namings. This is the first one. I'm going to take this as P1. Here I'm going to take this P2. Here it is P3. Here it is P4. Here it is P5, P6, P7, and here it is P8, okay? So now almost the work is done. This is our profile. So what we have to do is, with the HP pencil, just go for a dark line. Go for a dark line. You can get the profile. So in the question, we don't have any information to draw the tangent and normal. And at some point of view, in order to get a good mark, I recommend to draw the tangent and normal if it is not given in the question also, okay? So just take a tangent and normal at any point on the curve. So just I'm going to take a point on the curve. I'm going to pick this as the point. So same procedure what we have followed in the cycloid, we must follow in order to draw the tangent and normal. So this is a point. From this, what you have to do, just take the rolling circle in your compass and keep at the point which you have picked and go for a cut mark in the locus of the center. Here is the locus of the center. You will get an arc like this, okay? You'll get an arc like this, and from this, just drop a line 90 degree to the base, okay? And when you are dropping at the baseline, you will get the intersection on point. So from that, if you take a straight line just passing through the pick to point, I can say it's a normal n n dash. If you draw a very good 90 degree line just passing through the outer periphery by using the protractor, you can achieve it. If you draw a 90 degree line in the outer periphery of the curve, you can get the tangent t dash. So now the profile is over. Afterwards, we have to give the dimension work. We have to complete the dimension work. So here only we have the rolling circle as well angle, right? Angle is captured, and as well we have the pi into d length, that also captured. Only thing is, this diameter should be captured in the profile. So for that, here is the rolling circle. So from the fourth point, take a 90 degree line, just take a 90 degree extension line from each end. Okay, so afterwards just have a dimension line by capturing both the ends with the filled arrows and write pi 50 in the above of your dimension line. Okay, so now the dimension got over. The next thing is a texting work. So here just make a guidelines to write TT dash as tangent and NN dash as normal. So first of all, T dash is tangent, tangent, and write N dash as normal. So one more thing is remaining. We always used to take our measurement in mm, so we have to capture all dimensions are in mm. So just have a longer guideline with 5 mm gaps and write all dimensions are in mm. All dimensions are in mm. Okay, I hope you all understood how to construct it. Thank you so much. I will come up with another video.